Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Charles, and I welcome you guys to another episode of the Dreamers Pro Show, where we cover everything from sports, hot topics, classic debates, entertainment, and where we give you guys a fresh perspective on things and how we see them. And in today's episode, I got a pretty interesting one for you guys is, was John Sally right to compare Kawhi Leonard to Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant? So that's the topic I'm going to get into in today's video. But before we get into that, I want you guys to please make sure you go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell to be notified whenever we drop our content. Also, make sure you go ahead and check out Dreamers Pro Max, an online sports community, place you can go and start basketball discussions, chat live during games, so many of the cool things. So if you guys are interested in that, we have that link in the description. And also make sure you go and click the join button to become a member of our channel. So recently we just did a video talking about, I'm going to get to the thesis of this video here. We just did a video asking whether or not Kawhi Leonard should be traded. The Clippers should let Kawhi Leonard walk. And we did a poll on our channel where the majority of the people, 70% of the people said they should keep him, and 30% said he should walk. Let me just say this again. I forgot a point that I wanted to put in that video that I'm going to say here. Okay. It's like you asking a person that, you know, hey man, should I break up with my girlfriend? I don't know if she you know, I don't know, think she's the right one for me. And this, and he goes, yeah, you should break up. Yeah, definitely let her go, man. Yeah, you got to let her go, man. You got, not knowing that this dude or this chick is trying to get at your partner, right? It's like, yeah, let him go, man. Let him go. Yeah, you know, because they hollered at her and or him, and they turned him down. Now, yeah, let them. They not worth it, man. Let him go. Let him, like, yo, cut it out. Anyway, for like throwing that last point in. Anyway, so we know that sports is all about comparing players and comparing eras, and who would win, what team would beat that's pretty much what all sports is about. That's why I'm always floored when some people are, why would you make this type of argument? This is dumb. They didn't even play. It's like, bro, do you realize the genre in which you're in? That's all sports is about. What are we talking? Who would win, Michael Jordan or Kobe? Kobe or LeBron? Like, what are we talking about here? So when some people say that, I just feel like you need to just wake up, shake yourself, do a few jumping jacks, and realize you're talking sports here. And one of the recent comparisons that I've heard out there is this, was that some people out there have been trying to compare Devin Booker to Kobe Bryant, something I felt like was very premature, way too premature. Somebody that just has only made two All-Star teams, never made an All-NBA team, and you're talking about comparing him to the great Kobe Bryant. I didn't see the similarities on defense. Kobe was just not a scorer. He was a defensive player, clutch and all that. So I thought that was way too premature and just inaccurate, actually, to be quite honest with you. But some people felt like, oh, I feel it's a good one. Yeah, whatever, right? I feel like it's people that either don't know how good Kobe Bryant was, or people that are trying to diminish him. It's only LeBron James fans or somebody that is a noob in basketball, somebody that listens to Nick Wright or something like this, that feels like, oh, yeah, I can see it. Like, no, bro, you don't know what you're talking about. Like, cut it out. So I felt like, let me just kind of shoot that down. So people, you've been tough. Like, no, I've been accurate. Like, I don't see it, right? And people want you to see. No, I don't see it. I think in today's world, we try to compare. People love to compare people that don't deserve that comparison. Somebody will have one hot album and be like, yo, this is the greatest rapper of all time. Like, yo, cut that out, son. And when somebody says otherwise, oh no, this dude is hating. No. We keeping it real over here. We're just keeping it, it's too gully for you. But anyway, let me get into what I'm saying. So anyway, I always thought a better comparison was Kawhi Leonard to Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant. I always felt that was a more sensible comparison, right? Because it made more sense, right? There was much more validity to that type of comparison. And then it reminded me, because I was recently watching some John Sally interviews on Vlad. He has some pretty interesting takes on certain things, and he spoke about Scottie Pippen, he spoke about different things. And I remember that John Sally did kind of compare Kawhi Leonard to Michael Jordan a while ago, right? Number of months ago, I think it was 2-3 months. I don't remember the amount of months, but it was in the past. And I was like, huh, this is interesting. Let me go back and revisit this. So for some of you people that didn't hear him give his explanation as to why he feels Kawhi Leonard is similar to Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant, take a listen to some of his comments or some of his thoughts as to why he believes that these three players are quite similar. So take a listen to that.
Well, Doc Rivers said that Kawhi Leonard is the most like Jordan that he's ever seen.
Kobe Bryant is Michael Jordan plus.
Okay.
Kawhi Leonard has the hands of MJ, does not have the pizzazz, but that kill technique and that literally technical, when I get here, I shoot like exactly as I practice, yeah. But Kobe Bryant is Michael Jordan plus.
Now, in that soundbite, John Sally gives his explanation as to why he feels as if Kawhi Leonard and Kobe Bryant, as he spoke about their hands, you know, defensive players, you know, their ability to get to their spots and all of these different things. Something I always felt, right? And to me, I think it goes even a step further, because I agree with him. Now, here are my thoughts. First of all, Kawhi Leonard is not the offensive player. I think Kawhi is a hybrid between these two players, right? If you match these two players together, you shook them up, I think you get a player like Kawhi Leonard. Kind of like, you know, Max Kellerman said, if so-and-so had a baby, it would be Allen Iverson, something like that. Here's why. Kawhi Leonard is not the offensive player that Kobe Bryant or Michael Jordan was. He can't score at the rate at which these guys do, because they were more talented offensive players. And that's why you can see Kawhi Leonard's offensive game, as far as his footwork, the way he plays angles, you know, his mid-range, his form, and all of these things really went to another level once he started training with Kobe. This is something we all know, except the people that don't know. However, Kobe Bryant is not the defensive player that Kawhi Leonard is or was, or whatever you want to call it. And Kawhi plays defense to the level that Michael Jordan did, right? Here's why. Yes, Kobe made all 9 All-NBA first teams on defense, the exact amount that Michael Jordan did. But Kawhi has 2 Defensive Player of the Year awards. Jordan has 1. So he's closer to Jordan if we're talking about defense. He's also closer to Jordan if we're talking about efficiency, overall efficiency. Jordan's a 50% type of player, although Jordan didn't focus on 3. That's why I laugh at people when they try to make this whole argument about, well, Kobe wasn't that good if you look at his efficiency. Yeah, but Jordan wasn't a great 3-point shooter, so what? Like, again, cut it out. You're not talking to a fool here. Go spit that to somebody else. You're not going to win an argument just by that. Jordan wasn't the best 3-point shooter, right? So what does it mean? Stephen Curry has had a 50-40-90 season before. So what, Stephen Curry's better than Michael Jordan? Like, cut that out. It doesn't work with me. People try, but it doesn't work. There's more to it than just that, right? So I just wanted to quickly say that. So he's closer to Jordan when it comes to his defenses and his efficiency, but Kobe's much closer to Jordan when it comes to his offensive potency, but also Kobe's an all-defensive player. So when you kind of look at the combination of these things, obviously, if you look at their playing styles, it's very similar. I can kind of connect these pieces together, right? And I can see how they're very similar. Now, Kawhi Leonard, to me, is a top 15, top 20 player of all time. He's right there with Kevin Durant and Stephen Curry. I think he's better than Stephen Curry all time. I think most people agree with that point. I think most people have Kawhi Leonard ranked ahead of Stephen Curry right now, today, right? I think if you poll most GMs, they would pick Kawhi Leonard before they pick Stephen Curry. So Kawhi Leonard is the better player. I have him ranked higher than Stephen Curry all time. I think he's right there with Kevin Durant. I think he's right there. I think him and KD right there next to each other. They have similar accomplishments. KD has a very amazing career. Kawhi Leonard has a very amazing career, unique career. So I think he's in the top 15, top 20 range, and Stephen Curry would be behind those two players. I don't really think this is much of an argument. So that's why I have Kawhi Leonard. But I think he needs more titles to move further up the list, in my opinion. But I think John Sally has some points. I think he has some points. So what I want to know from you guys, what do you think about some of the things he said and some of the things that I said? Whatever you guys think, please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section below. Again, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to make sure you go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell to be notified whenever we drop our content. Once again, it's just Charles here from Dreamers Pro, wishing you guys an amazing day. Catch you guys on the next episode.